One of the key things that I was never really happy with in hockey games in general was how there is no real differentiation between the players. And I'm not even talking about some tiny fine-tuning in this case. What I'm talking about are such basics like that generally speaking, a player that is in a possession of the puck is less agile than a player with free hands. So I'm really happy that I was able to find and tune the code that is responsible for this in our hockey simulator. What I mean by that is not some kind of placebo, you can really feel it and see it. I made it actually a little too much for this footage, so you can better see it even like this on your screen. All this is multiplied by the various player attributes, so now we have that needed difference between the elite skater and let's say enforcer and everything between. This one is actually a pretty interesting topic. I see EA Sports has the exact opposite approach on this subject. We keep hearing them almost every year how they have improved their gameplay by making seamless this or seamless that. This year, for example, one of their biggest PR thing is that a player can't lose any speed during the puck pickups or while receiving a pass or shoot the puck. Well, while this might make probably some sense for a 4-minute arcade video game, that is not how the real hockey game works in the real world with the real physics. Actually, it's exactly opposite. So for the 2KHS, my goal is to try to simulate the real world hockey with every little nuances and with these extra layers make the gameplay more rich, alive, exciting and fun. So in 2KHS now both AI and human-controlled players lose some realistic speed while picking up the puck, passing the puck, during the pass reception, while dumping the puck, shooting the puck, during deeks, during the goalie deeks, when using the defensive or offensive skill stick, while turning and skating backwards, while poke checking, stick lifting or while attempting a hit. I also made it that a player can lose speed quicker if he goes from hustle to glide state. That means you or the AI can manipulate a player much precisely during this glide state. So these and some other changes makes sure that the gameplay is realistically dynamic. You can have very slow, sloppy and physical moments while fighting for the puck in the corner, for example. But at the same time, with a few smart passes, the gameplay can shift to a hectic, fast rush or breakaway, just like in the real life. One of the key tasks to make the skating and the all-around movement realistic and to feel right was to find a way how to separate the actual speed or distance from the animation that covers it. Let me explain real quick. So in the default game or in the NHL 20 from EA Sports, you can change, let's say, the skating speed with sliders. That means how long it takes a skater to move from a point A to the point B. You can make the skater move slow or fast. But what you can't do is to make the animations or the motion capture adjust accordingly to look really realistic. What I mean by that is when they have the animations of these games tuned for a hyper-fast arcade action and you make the actual movement slow with the sliders, the game starts to look kind of funny and off. Yes, the player now skates with a realistic speed, but his legs are still pumping crazy fast. You can't change this with sliders. So naturally, it all starts to look off and kinda comical. The same principles apply to shooting or passing, for example. Yes, you can change the speed of the puck, but the shooting and passing animations then start to look wrong because they were tuned for a very different game and attitude. So it was really important for me that I can tune all these pieces separately. I can now tune separately the speed and distance for both gliding animations, all free hustle animations, for a crossover animations, for a crossover animation while skating backwards, for a regular skating backwards animations, for a turning animation, and for a facing the puck animation. I was also able to separate the glide speed from a full hustle speed and from skating backward speed. So again, now I can tune all these pieces realistically as needed. Now you can really make your skater do all the subtle movement or sacrifice some of that precision while pushing the controller really hard and hustle. I was also able to correct the distance and momentum during the deeks, goalie deeks, shots, stumble shots, hitting and jostling. So all these changes are a very important piece of a puzzle in order to make the gameplay truly dynamic, exciting, realistic, and definitely not to feel like a single seamless animation.